talking about Jack Dempsey, and he had the shoulder twirl and the
drop step,
and you have to coordinate those two. So to drop the weight
into the throat.
Okay, and then he's coordinating the head movement with it. So these, the old guys call that an uppercut, and then turn it this way. Work at this point. Okay, so he wanted to draw a right hand, and he would do that with either his head or with a jab. He'd try to get him to throw the right hand, and he would go
under it.
And when that opponent's punch was supposed to be hitting his head, he would roll, and the body shot would be hitting that guy's body. Okay, so he's drawing this, he's banging that shot to the bottom, and he's looking for a reaction. Okay, he threw what he wanted, the right hand's going to go under it, now he's looking for the reaction. Either the guy's going to drop his hands or bend over from the body shot, and either one is the sign to throw the left hook. Okay. He comes here and the guy doesn't drop his hand, the left hook's coming, goes under. So he's got to draw the punch and then breathe and react. Okay, and when
the desired effect here,
he's coming with the left hook. So, he's going to work off with different punches. He's going to roll his head this way and throw the overhand right. But, for the basic combination of tactics, he's looking to draw the right hand,
go under it for the body shot, and then come with his
legs into the hook, and with a full power. Now you can punch up this way and throw the hook to the body with these motions. See a good modern example of this type of punching. Look at Ray Sepa.